Gymnastics has been championing women's sport since the 1950s, and the 2019 edition will once again showcase the country's best female gymnasts, who first competed for a national title in 1959. The importance of having an outstanding female level of participation not lost on Gymnastics Australia Chief Executive Officer, Kitty Chiller.
To see it now go from strength to strength and have almost 1,500 athletes competing and over 1,000 females 60 years later is quite incredible.
Women's artistic gymnastics coach Mihai Brestian says the championships are crucial in selecting the team for the world titles.
It's very important for me to see who I can trust to put it in a team, based on the results, based on the attitude, based on the desire, determination, dedication, all these kind of things will be taken into consideration when we choose the team.
After injuries over the past year, Alexandra Eid is aiming to hit back at Melbourne Arena.
I'm really hoping that I can come out here and prove that, you know, I have been injured, but I was still working really hard behind the scenes, and that I want that to show this week.
All gym sports disciplines will feature over the fortnight of competition, with rhythmic gymnast Alexandra Kiroi-Bogatorova one to watch.
I enjoy the Australian Championships because, once again, it's the home ground, Melbourne, and rhythmic gymnastics is my passion, it's my hobby, it's my lifestyle, and it's what I do.
The Melbourne event has 1,470 athletes across the junior and senior ranks, with the men's competition featuring New Zealand as part of the Oceania Continental Championships.
That's to determine the one Oceania place that's left in the World Artistic Championships in Stuttgart later this year. So Australia and New Zealand will be going head-to-head and seeing who comes out on top and wins that prize position.
The championships continue at Melbourne Arena through to the 4th of June.